Hey Leute, willkommen zurück zu Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Im letzten Part haben wir uns hier in der Pfandleihe von Windy Bank noch ein bisschen weiter umgesehen, als plötzlich eine Kundin hier eingetreten ist, nämlich diese Dame da, die wir kennen. Gina the Straight ist hier!
Oh, yes, it's a young lady from Mr. McGillett's trial 2 months ago.
Her name is Gina the Straight, my lord. She's a chancer. Earns her crust among large crowds, relieving people of their purses. What's commonly called a pickpocket. Hallo.
Gordon Bennett, you lot!
Ja, bleib doch ruhig, Mann. Warum haben wir alle Waffen eigentlich hier?
Hello, Mr. Straight. I hope you've been well.
What? You remember me then, do you?
Well, I remember being completely surrounded by smoke, that's for sure. So, what are you doing in here? Down and out, like the rest of us. Nothing to eat. Come to pop that black weasel, sorry, coat of ya. Of ya.
What is it about this black uniform that makes everyone comment on it? Haha, good day. Unless I'm much mistaken. You would be the young pickpocket who stole our experimental smoke grenade launcher. Ah, stimmt tatsächlich, ja.
Ah, Mr. Sholmes.
Oder hat sie den gestohlen? Oder hat Iris ihr den gegeben sogar? Ich glaube, den hat sie von Iris sogar geschenkt bekommen. Glaube ich. Weil am Ende von der Verhandlung mit McGilded haben wir auch Iris zum ersten Mal getroffen. Und da war auch dann Gina da, glaube ich. So, you have something of value to pawn, do you? Allow me to see the article, and I shall negotiate with Mr. Windybank on your behalf.
Pull the other one. I don't need no help from some stuck-up D. Get out of my business. Go on, or I'll make trouble for ya.
As you wish, Mr. Straight. I will happily remove myself from your presence.
He's really done it. He's gone.
I'm sorry, but as I said, there really is no room for negotiation here.
What is the thing he has in his hand? Some kind of metal disc?
And you? Go on, leave me alone! Oh, Mr. Straight, just pretend we aren't here. We shan't be offended in the slightest.
Susato-san can really stand her ground when she wants to.
Whatever.
Okay, dann gehen wir halt mit Gina ein bisschen. Pawnbrokers Customer. Ja, halt. Ja, was soll das denn jetzt heißen? Dass sie halt jetzt eine Kundin ist hier bei der Pfandleihe. Oder wie? Das ist sehr komisch aufgeschrieben, finde ich. Somehow, I didn't really think you were the sort of person who'd use a pawnbroker, Mr. Straight. Ja doch, weil sie hier alles klaut. Und das dann hier abgibt.
Yeah, well I am, alright. I'm a Londoner, just like everyone else. That a problem, is it?
No, no, not at all. It's just that, well...
Oh, I get it. I know what you're thinking. That thing probably don't even belong to her. Probably got it on the dive, didn't she?
Yeah, ehrlich gesagt schon.
Yeah, I can see it written all over your Chevy Chase.
Well, I might have been thinking something along those lines.
You're not going to deny it, Mr. Naruhodo.
Ich hab's ja auch gedacht.
Alright then, I'm just going to come out and ask you straight. Do you pawn things that you steal from other people?
Well, I don't know how best to answer that, really. Suppose, sometimes. You're not going to deny it either, Miss Lestrade. But not this time, alright? I swear, that thing belongs to me.
The disc that Mr. Windybank is holding. Ist das so eine Art Schallplatte oder so? Ich glaube sogar schon. Mit der kann dann Musik gespielt werden.
Perhaps you should see what he has to say about all this.
Achso, okay, mit ihm jetzt reden. Okay, so, hi. Ah, zwei Sachen sogar, okay. Miss Lestrade's Disc und sie selber. Ich würde sogar zuerst eigentlich über sie selber reden wollen, aber ich mach's immer von oben nach unten. Also die komische Disc, diese komische Scheibe von Miss Lestrade.
Mr. Windybank, what exactly is this metal disc that Mrs. Strait has brought in? It seems to have hundreds of tiny little bumps on its surface.
Ah, this is a music disc, you see. For use inside a music box.
In a music box?
What? You don't even know what a music box is? Your Eastern Lord ain't too savvy, eh?
I know what a music box is. I've just never seen one of these discs before.
The small protrusions on the metal disc encode the tune to be played by the music box. You simply insert the disc and set the machine going, and beautiful music plays.
It's so incredible! Tell us, what tune is on this disc?
Well, I'm afraid I couldn't tell you that. There are so many different types of music box, you see. British made, German...
German, yay!
Swiss... I have no way of knowing which particular machine this disc was made for.
Ah, I see.
And that's it in a nutshell. I wouldn't have any customers for an item like this, even if the young lady forfeited it. Really, I'm already offering more than I should at a penny.
That's a packet of lies! He told me he did. He said it was, well...
He? Who?
Never you mind. It just ain't right, that's all. That disc's worth good money, I know it is.
Well then, you'll have to try your luck at another pawnbroker's, won't you?
Okay, dann reden wir über China.
She's been in before, of course, this little tatterdemalion.
I see.
And brought some dubious article or other with her every single time, I might add.
Dubious? What are you trying to say? I'm an honest customer, me?
So, is there something dubious about the disc she brought in today?
Well, if only it were that simple.
Sorry? What do you mean?
What she actually brought in was a storage ticket.
Ah, a storage ticket. So, Mr. Strait has actually come to redeem an article from you today, is that right? Yeah, that's right. A girl like me has a lot of stuff what needs storing.
Alright, yes, that's definitely dubious.
The article in question would have been forfeited at midnight tonight.
Ich muss mal ausgucken, wie man dieses komische Wort ausspricht, wo ich immer forfeited sag. Wird das wirklich forfeit? Nee, ich glaub nicht. Das kommt so oft vor, warte mal. Doch, passt sogar. Nur die Betonung noch ein bisschen mehr auf der ersten Silbe, also forfeit. Aber ja.
But as she gave me the ticket for it and repaid both the loan and the interest, I was obliged to return the article to her.
But what was the article? Do tell us, Mr. Windybank.
The little scamp is wearing it, ma'am.
Ah.
It's the overcoat that she redeemed.
Oh.
What? What's wrong with that? It fits, don't it? I mean, it's mine, so of course it does. So, what about the disc then? How does that come into all this?
Oh, the disc is something else. A new article to pawn, if the girl and I can agree a price.
Okay. Hey, da dürfen wir jetzt nochmal nachfragen. Das gibt ja auch gar keinen Sinn. Wir haben doch gerade oben, gerade hier schon über die Disc nachgefragt. Und jetzt nochmal über den neuen Artikel. Nämlich die Disc. Naja, frag mal halt nochmal nach.
I'm confused. I thought you said that Mr. Strait brought in a storage ticket today. It's really quite simple. Yes, the child brought me a storage ticket and the money owed on it, as we say.
For this heavy black coat, which you returned to her care, as I'd understood it.
That's right, yes. And rather unsurprisingly, as soon as the little ragamuffin put the thing on, she went rifling through the pockets.
Oh, you mean...
What? Do you know it's true to stare at a lady? Ah, I see. So it came from the pocket of the overcoat, did it?
Okay.
If you mean this, then yes, exactly, ma'am.
And she immediately tried to pawn it?
For quite a high price as well. This is all rather suspicious, I think. Yeah.
Give it up! I'm just trying to pawn something like anyone else would. Mr. Strait, may I ask who deposited the overcoat here in the first place? Well, me?
It doesn't really appear to be your size.
Me, old man! It's me, old man's, ain't it? Is it, Mr. Straits?
Yes, this is definitely all rather suspicious.
Out of my way, please! Was geht eigentlich gerade ab?
Hallo?
Who's this picture postcard English gentleman?
Good day to you, ladies, gentlemen.
What's your problem, eh?
There is no problem, as long as you remove yourself. I have a matter to discuss with the proprietor. And if you intend to make a problem of it, I shall see you outside, little girl, for the hiding you deserve.
Look, ain't it obvious? I ain't done talking with him yet. If you think you're such a gent, you should know how to wait in line.
Well, you are an impudent little brat, aren't you?
Nicht so ein großer Gentleman.
As well as a pickpocket.
Eh? Who are you? How do you know who I am?
The question is, how do you not know who I am? You haven't the courtesy even to remember the faces of your victims, it seems.
What? You mean I... from you?
Broker.
Yes, sir.
I believe this filthy pocket thief has just redeemed an article from you, no?
Yes.
The article in question belongs to me. I demand for it to be returned at once.
Oh my! No, that's a lie. What are you trying to pull?
Give me back my overcoat, you wastrel. And needless to say... Any music box discs too.
Warum machen alle so komische Posen in dem Spiel?
No, you can't have it. You just can't. It's me, old man's. Or it was. Now it's mine. Goodness, Mr. Naruhodo. This is a very awkward situation.
Yes. I think perhaps we should hear both sides of the story a little more in detail.
Ich glaube eigentlich nicht, dass China lügt. Gerade sie wirkt nicht so, als würde sie lügen. Wir reden nochmal mit ihr erstmal. The Gentleman's Accusation, die Beschuldigung von dem Gentleman.
Mr. Straight, is what the Gentleman is saying? What do you think? It's all lies, ain't it? Obviously. I swear on my life, I ain't never laid eyes on that dandy before.
Let's hear it now, you little ragamuffin. You stole it, didn't you? That ticket you brought in here just now.
No, I swear it. I swear to God.
It was barely an hour ago. I was walking along the street, minding my own business, when this little gatherling ran into me. I knew at once what had happened. I've been robbed yet again, I thought to myself. Those wretched pickpockets.
Yet again?
Oh yes, as you can see, I am a man of impeccable style. This isn't the first time that I've been targeted by these backslum scoundrels. Now then, relinquish my overcoats.
Come along now, Mr. Straight. Give the good gentleman his coat back. If you're going to cause trouble, I shall have no choice but to call the police.
Hold on, why does everything think it's me? Just look at this dandy cove, and you think I'm the dodgy one?
I'm sorry, but no one's going to believe you.
Well, what about evidence? Yeah. Where's your evidence that I've stolen something, eh? Come on, let's see it.
Oh, I have evidence, naturally.
You what?
Evidence. Aber ich würde erstmal sagen, dass das hier war für diesen Part von Let's Play The Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Auch wieder einiges passiert. Wir wissen den Namen von dem Typen noch nicht mal, ne? Habe ich in der Gerichtsakte dann auch noch nicht, natürlich. Stimmt, wir können es noch ganz kurz vielleicht ihn hier durchlesen. Hier, die anderen kennen wir ja schon, Gina the Straight auch, oder ist da was Neues? A young pickpocket who we first met during a trial 2 months ago. Ja, schon ein bisschen. She and Iris have become firm friends since. Okay. Eine junge Diebin, die wir zum ersten Mal bei der Verhandlung vor 2 Monaten kennengelernt haben. Und sie und Iris sind seitdem jetzt dicke Freunde geworden. Der andere, ich glaube, bei denen ist der Text ziemlich gleich geblieben. Ich glaube sogar exakt gleich. Hier nicht ganz. Above whose lodgings, Mr. Sato and I rent our own office and rooms. Genau. Über seinem Büro, halt im Prinzip bin halt ich und Susato, sagt er da. Und hier ist auch dasselbe. Okay, aber jetzt eher noch kurz. Pop Windyberg, 48. Okay, Pop übrigens auch. Vornamen verstehe ich auch. Das hat der Sholmes erklärt, dass man Items da poppt, also ihm übergibt und man dafür halt dann Geld bekommt. The proprietor oder so of a pawnbrokery on Baker Street that is regularly patronized by Mr. Sholmes. He has a very great sense of responsibility to his clients. Ja, ich weiß nicht, was Proprietor heißt oder so. Chef halt wahrscheinlich in dem Fall. Ja, Moment. Inhaber. Passt noch besser. Also der Inhaber von der Pfandleihe hier in der Baker Street, der regelmäßig von Mr. Sholmes, da habe ich auch nachgeschaut, wie man das am besten übersetzen kann, weil da passen so ziemlich alle Bedeutungen, die ich gefunden habe. man könnte entweder unterstützen sagen oder fördern, weil er hat ihm ja auch die Kameras zum Beispiel gegeben, die beiden, die Überwachungskameras. Aber man könnte ja auch herablassend behandeln oder gönnerhaft behandeln, könnte man auch nehmen. Er wird auch ein bisschen genervt, einfach nur von Sholmes, hat man ja auch schon gemerkt. Ja. Und er hat auf jeden Fall einen großen Sinn für Verantwortung gegenüber seinen Klienten. Ja. Weil bei einem Fehler würde es sich auch sogar das Leben nehmen. Gut, aber jetzt würde ich eben sagen, was ist hier? Beim nächsten Mal reden wir da noch ein bisschen weiter mit China und auch diesem anderen komischen Typen da. Ich glaube ja eigentlich, also sie will es ja trotzdem nicht so ganz zugeben, also ich weiß nicht, ob es ihrer ist oder der von ihrem Vater, wie sie sagt, oder so. Das glaube ich auch nicht so richtig, aber ich glaube ja auch nicht, dass sie ihn gestohlen hat. Ich glaube nicht, dass er dem einen Typen gehört, bei dem glaube ich noch weniger. Den finde ich direkt zu Beginn gleich sehr unsympathisch. Und China finde ich eigentlich sogar halbwegs sympathisch, auch wenn sie eine Diebe ist. Aber ja, wir gucken beim nächsten Mal. Ich hoffe, wir können das da auflösen und klären, wem der Mantel gehört. Okay, also dann Leute, bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.